All right, Charlie celebrated his first Mass at St. Mary's on the day following his ordination, namely Sunday, June the 25th. It was an evening Mass attended by many of his friends, and on the altar are participating many of his friend seminarians, and also Father Petrini, who was the pastor of St. Mary's and was very helpful to Charlie during his years when he worked there. Charlie began at St. Mary's while he was in George Mason University, directing the choir, singing in the choir, and playing the organ, and continued through that time. And to this very day, he still participates in St. Mary's at various Tridentine Masses, wedding ceremonies, and other functions. The homily was given by Monsignor Awol, who had been his director and a mentor while Charlie served at St. Anne's Parish during his seminary years also. St. Mary's is a beautiful old church, was originally built by the German families who at that time lived in the area. It is located at 5th and G Streets in Washington.
Yeah, just coincidentally, I was still practicing law at the time, and my practice was situated right nearby at the Superior Court, where I represented criminal defendants for 4 or 5 years.
Yes, at this time the church is located next to Chinatown and on the other side next to the Court District of Washington. In the following pictures, you will see Nana Pope and various family members, as well as the priest participating on the altar.
So I guess we're about ready to go into the film. I guess we should make the usual point that we made in the past in these recordings, that this entire tape is very lengthy. It's about an hour and 45 minutes, and it is abridged, and I trust that we've done a satisfactory job on that.
Yes, and we should give credits once again to Charlie's uncle Dave Clem and his cousin John Clem, who did the filming.
Great job.
Yes.
Of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. suffered, and then took the cup. Again, he gave thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory."
So many different ways by what you said, if nothing else is hanging, then keep going.
meant a lot to me. Your prayers, I don't think that we could ever appreciate in this life all the values of prayers that we have for one another. When we get to heaven, then it will be clear to us how really interrelated we were and how much our prayers for one another really did make a difference. I am firmly convinced that one person praying can avert war. How much more so than when so many people pray. So I can only affirm what Father Petrini said, that vocations come from a prayer for people. You have to pray not only for the vocation that God would call people, but that the people whom he called would answer. Not just vocation to the priesthood, but so much to the religious life, to be a religious brother or a religious sister. So I ask you to continue to pray for vocations. I would like to make some individual thanks. I say I have my greatest apologies that I can't thank each of you individually, but I would like to thank Monsignor A. Walsley. He's had such a good influence on me over the last 2 years, and I can't thank you enough for coming and preaching at this Mass. I have benefited so much from Monsignor's great generosity. All the people at St. Andrews, and so many of you out here now. You're a very generous parish, and I will miss not being with you. I'm being sent to Mount Calvary Parish in Forestville, Maryland, which means I'll be sent into a new parish, but I've been with the people at St. Andrews for the last 2 summers, really on and off for the last 2 years, and I cannot thank all of you enough. Your prayers and your support have been so much to me. Thank you again, my dear. I want to thank the musicians. A lot of you who know me know that I'm pretty opinionated about maternal things. And I firmly believe one of the most beautiful heritages liturgically of the church is our beautiful heritage of sacred music. And I hope that you can appreciate me tonight, just a brief glimpse of that. Mr. Mike Donaldson and Don Clark, Bill Parsons especially, done so much to bring that beautiful music to this church, not only at this Mass, but throughout the last 2 years. It's meant so much to me to be able to pray with you while you sing. And I have to do one more thing before we finish Mass. As you all know, that we who are Catholics believe very firmly not only in the prayers that we who are among the living here on earth, we also believe very firmly in the intercession of all the saints and the angels in heaven on our behalf. Just as we pray for one another, they also pray for us. And the Queen of all saints, Mary our Mother, has been very close to me and dear to my heart, and I consecrated my vocation to her on my very first day in seminary. Now I would like to consecrate my priesthood in a very special way to her and her Immaculate Heart. What I'll do is I'll go over to the side altar and I will read a prayer which I've adapted from the Marian Movement of Priests, which I'm a member of. And that's on page 5 of the program. If you'd like to follow along with me, pray with me that I be a good and holy priest through the intercession of our Blessed Mother. I also ask Father John Dunnington, who is my spiritual director in the seminary, who is also a member of the Marian Movement, come stand by me and witness in a very special way my consecration of my priesthood to the Mary of the Immaculate Heart. final blessing for man.